everyone เจริญพรญาติโยม May I speak in English sometime in Thai sometime I have heard you here from organization of the United States from United Nations, right? Yeah, thank you. I would like to welcome you all to practice meditation here in Young Buddhist Association of Thailand. Some of you are Thai. Anyone Thai, please show your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and non-Thai. Okay, non-Thai. How about you? Half. non-Thai. Who from the Philippines? Yeah. And Japan. How about you? Two of you. And the last one, man. Where are you from, sir?
Australia.
Okay. You know, in our life, it's very lucky for all of you to take meditation course, even once in life. Why I can say or I dare say like that? Because meditation is our life, not only part of our life, it's main everything of our life. Some of you have practiced meditation. Anyone have practice meditation before? Please show your hand. Everyone. Oh, now you experience. Great. Meditation, everyone know, is benefit. More or less, it depends on how you integrate them into your daily life. Integrate it into your daily life, your life. It's like your second friend, meditation. I would like to start with my experience and general talk about the ceremony first, why we have to have the ceremony, like we take the five precepts, and some ceremony, the determination or undertaking, you know, to no talk, or we say noble silence. Noble silence is mean while practicing meditation. No talking or talk. Talks are not allowed. I would like to talk this kind of step first. In Buddhism, even you are non-Buddhist, some of you non-Buddhist, but don't worry. You can practice meditation as well, because meditation is not monopolized or special only for Buddhists, but meditation for all. The three step or training role, we call the training, threefold training in Buddhism, why you have the ceremony like a five precept undertaking. even in Pali language, a very ancient language, the language of Theravada Buddhism. But we translate into Thai or into any languages, you can understand by the first step, the sila or morality. We say precepts, five precepts. The five precepts, or even the next step, eight precepts, 10 precepts, or even 227 precepts, or even for Bhikshuni in Theravada, 331 precepts. Or even in the Mahayana Vajrayana tradition, they have more numbers than Theravada for the monks. But for lay people, five precepts enough. Because more than that is very confusing. Even monk, you know, does not mean we can remember, we can understand all, but only the major offense, major apatti or offense. So for the precept so important, it's like the background, the platform of the building, of the structure. Without precept, without morality, without, or maybe you can say ethics, how you can practice meditation very well? Even you can practice meditation or concentration meditation, but that's not mean you can practice very, very well. I myself have experience, or even the others, they have experience as well. If you break one of the five precepts or one of the eight precepts, does not mean you practice meditation very well. You can practice. Even in Thailand, our culture, our Buddhist culture, but Thai Buddhist culture. In Western right now, they have the Western Buddhist culture. They have their own culture. They start with the wisdom. They start with the wisdom, not start with the sila like in Thailand. In Thailand, we start with the morality. And then concentration. And the last one for the threefold training, wisdom. You have wisdom, but does not mean you have concentration. You have concentration, but does not mean you have precept. That's why we have the ceremony to check your precept, five precept. Have you ever break your precept? But if you are ever you broke your precept, any precept, any training rule, you should undermine, or you should undertake the new that you want to precept, or you want to observe that precept. For example, you have drink alcohol, or the fifth precept, and then you during the rainy season, you should or no, you must quit that behavior, or even the first one, not taking the life of other, including destroy their life or even violate whatever you, break the rights of other, right of life. That's the first one. The second one, the objects, beloved objects. The first one, beloved light. The second object, second precept, beloved objects. You have beloved objects, whatever. You have beloved things. You possess, you contend with. For example, your clothes, your money, your facilities, whatever. But if you steal the other's object, you break the second rule. And then this is the second, the second precept. The third precept is about sensual misconduct. Maybe we can say adultery, but adultery very narrow. It's not broad like a sensual misconduct. For sensual misconduct, not only you have the, to violate or to break the third precept, that means the person, the beloved person of the other. For example, their daughter, their son, their family members, or whoever, and then you you steal, and then you, never ask for permission. That means you overlap, you violate, you break this kind of the third precept as well. If you break, your mind not peaceful. And the first one is about telling a lie. Anyone, maybe some of you, maybe right now, they say white lies. Okay? Maybe dark lies or white lies. The government, you know. How about you? Maybe say you have, told a lie to somebody. This is the first precept. It depends on your intention. Not enough intention, your effort as well. But you have intention, but you have no effort. The second precept, the breaking of the third precept, not complete, or every precept. And the last one, alcohol, or about the intoxicant, or even the drugs, everything about contaminate your mind, your body, even destroy your health, destroy your health. That's the fifth precept. That's enough in our life. Five precept is enough. If you can follow, if you can practice, observe the five precept, you can stay, you can live a long life. But if you break the five precept, your life, die untimely death is prematurely, right? So thus we should consider this kind of the five precepts. That's why we have this kind of ceremony for you to undertake the five precepts. And then you reflect what you have done, what you have about the five precepts. And this for Buddhist especially in Thailand, Sri Lanka, Burma or Myanmar, or even Laos in ASEAN, right? So they practice Theravada Buddhism, Theravada tradition. So five precepts, this way of life, their way of life. If you are Buddhist, the real Buddhist. So if, how about if you are non-Buddhist? For example, you from the Philippines, you can practice five precepts. You can practice meditation. Of course, because five precepts is not for only Buddhists by tradition, but is for the human beings, for the humanities. If you are human of the Philippines or Filipino, you are human. Yeah, we are human. I mean Thai human. Australian, you are human? Yes, of course. Japanese, how about you? You are human. If you are human, you can practice meditation, you can observe the precepts. But it depends on the religion, depends on the tradition as well. So open mind to learn different tradition, different culture, or even different religion. Most we practice our religion by tradition. We follow our father, mother, family members, or even the old generation. But sometimes we never question. But right now, I think it's good time for us is to learn a varieties of religion, variety of culture through globalization. So important, globalization in our world. We can learn from each other. Before we are like index, you know, index or minority. We live the outer world, we don't know each other. But right now, we get close. And then we can learn from each other more. This is the first step for you to keep in your mind for the five precepts, okay? Even in your daily life or even meditation course. And then concentration or calming, calmness. Or even you can say one-pointedness. This the second level we call samadhi. Samadhi, in Thai, or concentration, calmness. Samadhi from Pali language, this means one-pointedness of mind. If you focus something, do something, and your mind there, only one object, firmly, constantly, and then your mind very calm, very silent. So that's concentration, is the second one. And the last level, panya or wisdom. May I ask you, wisdom and knowledge the same or not? Maybe some of you have a loss of knowledge, but that means you have wisdom. Hello? So wisdom and knowledge, Some of you finish PhD. For example, me in front of you. I finish PhD and after that, I had accident, broken leg, with broken leg. I have a loss of knowledge. But that's not mean I have wisdom in this sense. For example, I would like to explain wisdom and knowledge. Knowledge, maybe you can gain from the external source. For example, from internet, from Facebook, from whatever, you know, media, you know, a lot of things you can learn from. You can gain knowledge. But that's not mean your knowledge be transformed into wisdom. Wisdom arises within yourself. In Buddhism, wisdom is so important. Only through your reflection, system reflection, that's why we have meditation. So please distinguish, please tell the difference between knowledge and wisdom. Two of these cannot be separate, but interconnected, you know. The more you have information, the more you have knowledge. First, you start with data. In our today world, we have a lot of data. In social world, in internet, multimedia, right? But some data is take that data. But data can be information. That's why we call the age of information technology at this time. In our age, the age of information technology. But not enough information. We have to learn and to analyze until it become a knowledge, and knowledge to wisdom. Wisdom from you. That's why you come here. You want to gain the wisdom by yourself, from yourself, through yourself. You have yourself as the teaching tool. No need for Facebook. This time, when you gain wisdom, you have to look within to understand more about yourself. That's the true wisdom. Why? Because to eliminate your egoness, and then to develop more wisdom, to understand more about life, how it's going on, naturally. So in Buddhism, we have three steps, right? One, morality. The second, concentration. And the last one, wisdom. In Thai, we call sin, samadhi, panya. You practice only one, it's not enough. Maybe some of you, I don't want morality. I don't want concentration. Only wisdom I need. No, impossible. You can practice, but it's not complete. For example, your building, right? This building, the building have many steps from down to up. You know, it's not only one structure, one components, but many factors that make this building the same. Meditation you practice does not mean you have only wisdom, but concentration as well, morality as well. It means three in one, okay? Three in one, or one in three, no? That means you come here, you come to practice meditation, but you gain one, sila, morality, samadhi, and the last one, panya or wisdom, okay? So, important in our life. We never thought like this before, because in your life, it's very hectic, you know, stressful, you know. Just only have what to finish to achieve your career, your success in your life, you know. But that's not mean that kind of thing is flexible, you know, and changeable, you know. Even your happiness, your fun, your pleasure, you know, one day it turn into suffering, you know. That's we should understand more about ourselves through meditation practice. I would like to share experience with you, because I become a Buddhist monk or novice. Before monk, we call novice monk for 8 years, and then monk for 10 years. So in more than 10 years, about 12 years. In monastic life, I have been living in monastic life for about 20 years. I have experienced about meditation before, as you know, as the young people in general. Never, even I turn a novice, you know, turn novice, but I never take interest in meditation. I hate meditation as well, you know. But when the more I practice, I went to study a bachelor level. At that time, we have the meditation course. After that, I got more and more interest in meditation. And even I think it's a meditation helped me about the serious accident this time, you know. When I had accident after my convocation, very, very, I mean, hurt, and my broken, I mean, leg. How I do? How I can do? I thought of meditation. If you are in difficult time, meditation can help you. But if you are in happy time or party time, no meditation. But in a hard time, difficult time, very useful meditation, you know, very in use. So at that time, I used meditation to understand the, we say, sensation or feeling, you know, the feeling. A very stressful, very painful, you know. Then we use meditation. After at that time, you know, I practice meditation 1 month course, and then I had accident. I think it's a proper time for me to use meditation, and I understand some of them, they had accident, you know. Why they die? Because very painful. But I think I'm very lucky to use meditation. And then I know how to acknowledge the feeling, the sensation, to separate body and mind. How do that? Body and mind. You can use even my body very painful, but my mind not painful. But after that, even it's painful as well. But it's okay. It's like minimize my pain. So meditation is helps a lot. For example, in your daily life as well, you have experience. The more you practice, even in your workplace, you know, you can acknowledge the, objects. Object is mean the thing that come to you. That's object, to say hello to you, to say something to you. You know, that's the object. We call the external object or the minor object come to you all the times. You know, in your workplace, in your home, your home place, or wherever, you know, especially two places. You can meditate by this kind of meditation in this center or this technique. I think is good for daily life because you can apply into your daily life. For example, someone talk ill of you or talk back about you, you can let it go. How do that? It's not easy. It look like simple, but without practicing, without accumulating your practice, does not mean you can get rid of this kind of feeling, this kind of situation. How you deal with it? How you manage this kind of thing? One thing, after I had accident, I wrote a book, three book. But before, I wrote some books. After I wrote how to deal with anger, how to deal with sensuality, how to deal with sorrow. I wrote three books, but in Thai. I think it can help you to deal with this kind of emotion in your daily life. I think it's if you're still human and living in this world, every day or one day, you must experience this kind of thing. But you know, you are very lucky to practice meditation here. You know, a lot of them, take the bus or they travel here and there. You know, you see, they have no opportunity, you know, to practice meditation here. But you have a good, we call a kalyanamitra or a spiritual friends or companion, you know, to help you. But sometimes even you are not happy at first, but after that, I think you get to love it and understand it. Whatever you do it by, by your light, you can do it very well. In Buddhism, we call chanda, or your willingness. You are willing to do, and then you can do very well. Albert Einstein, he said about the imagination, right? But we can continue imagination with the inspiration. Inspiration is mean you are inspired to do to practice meditation. In Buddhism, the Buddha start with the chanda or willingness or loving. If you love to do to practice, you can do very well. And after that, meditation will help you. Benefit you if you are familiar with it. For example, the sportsman, sportswoman, the more they practice, the more they are skillful, right? And then when they are skillful, they can do very well during match, during the game. So the same as you are practice meditation, you are in this course. When the game or the situation come to you, you can do very well, and then you can overcome that situation. But right now, it's time to practice. It's time to, accumulate your skill, how to deal with your emotion, any emotion, come to you. This, I think, is good for you, to have a good opportunity to not only work. Sometimes when we work all the time, we know only how to work. We have a skill, or we are skillful about working. But that's not mean you are skillful about spending life, or about your life, or about your dealing with emotion, whatever emotion come to you. But meditation can help you all to do that. So I think it's in this a good opportunity wherever you are, wherever you are from. Right now, you are a lucky person, to practice meditation. Try to think to the underprivileged people, or even they do not have a good opportunity like you, And then you try to practice more and more. Especially this technique, I guarantee, it help you. Even in the beginning, difficult. this technique is not like the other technique. In Thailand, where many techniques, in Thailand. Anyone have ever practiced the other techniques before? Not rising, falling. This technique is rising, falling. And some of you, have you ever practiced the other technique of meditation before? For example, พุทโธใครเคยปฏิบัติมั้งครับพุทโธเคยไหมสัมมาอรหังอ๋อสัมมาอรหังแล้วก็เทคนิคอย่างอื่นมีไหม The other technique maybe some of practice พุทโธสัมมาอรหังสัมมาอรหัง this technique maybe you practice rising falling, rising, falling in the beginning, very, very difficult. But it's help after that. Because this technique, they focus at mindfulness. what the meaning of mindfulness. Mindfulness, not concentration, but concentration, many levels of concentration. We use the short or momentary concentration as foundation, as a base for practicing mindfulness meditation. In the West, they use the mindfulness meditation for this kind of technique. We call vipassana. Have you heard this word, vipassana? Anyone? Thank you. Vipassana is mean to see thing or to understand things what they are or as they are, you know, as they are, not we want it to be, but just to observe what they are, or they really are, or as they are, you know, or as it is, you know, when we see something, not as you want it to be, like yourself, like your preference, you know, like your like, no, not vipassana. Vipassana does to observe things around you. In this technique, we have two objects. One main objects, and the second minor objects, or the main objects, rising, falling, and the sub object or minor object, the objects around you, whatever. Maybe your thinking, your sensation, your feeling, or even the things occur, you know, outside, and then our mind, our eye, ear, you know, nose, tongue, touches, you know, contact, you know, make contact with the outside, and then be aware. In this technique, this mean you have to, see, to observe, not to recite. If you are recite, for example, rising, falling, all the time, this is recite, not observe. Observe or acknowledge or note, we can say a note, take a note, make note, yeah, make note. Make note is mean be aware, rising when your abdomen rise, when your abdomen down or falls, you say falling, rising, falling, rising, falling. You may have question why you do not focus on the breath. Even the Buddha used this technique of the breath. You have any doubts? For the Buddha and his disciple, distinguished disciple in his time, he has the perfection, you know, the perfection to reach nirvana, to attain enlightenment, start with sotapanna, stream entry, anakami, sakatakami, anakami, until arahat. The achievements. So until you reach the stream entry, this level, the level of stream entry, you know, that's your faith unshakable in the Triple Gem, in the Buddha, in the Dhamma, in the Sangha. Even in Buddhism, we never, stress on faith. But the faith only beginning must start with the wisdom. Faith happen with wisdom. Otherwise, it would be blind faith, you know. So faith and wisdom go together. It's like we have the two legs. I have one leg. Cannot go together very well, you know. So this meditation, the Vipassana lead you to the achievement, attainment, or we can say enlightenment. Yeah, until your enlightenment. Enlightenment is mean you are mindful all the time. Even the stream enter is mean one who reach stream entry, sotapanna. Doesn't mean they are all full of the mindfulness. No. Until you reach nirvana. Nirvana is the final destination. It's not like a kingdom of God. Maybe the different concept. It's not like a paradigm, no. Nirvana is a state of the mind. When the more you practice meditation, the more you reach, you get closer to nirvana, to nippon. But don't worry about nippon. Practice first. Don't have more, over expectation, right? But right here and now, you practice, and then nirvana reach you, not you reach nirvana, something like that. So I share some the basic practice of meditation, and then I talk about five precepts as the foundation for next level concentration and wisdom. And then I talk about my experience a little bit about Vipassana meditation. I think is some of you may have a doubt in your mind. So about 20 minutes, you can raise your hand and ask the question about this practice, or even you have a doubt anything in your mind about Buddhism, about meditation practice, whatever, please, I open the floor. Okay. ใครจะมีปัญหาถามก็เจริญพรถามได้ประมาณ20นาทีเมื่อกี้โยมประธานมาบอกเหลือเวลาบรรยายถึง11นาฬิกาก็ open the floor for you. Maybe some of you have the question before practice, before meditation time, or even after meditation time you have question as well, you know. Don't worry. If you have no question, I have a question. Okay? My question is, what the difference between concentration meditation and mindfulness or vipassana meditation.Could you please tell me the different concentration, meditation, and mindfulness or vipassana meditation? Anyone can help me? You have some knowledge? How about you? Guys?Yeah, concentration and mindfulness. Samatha และวิปัสสนาแตกต่างกันยังไง Before you practice. Yes. Oh, don't worry. ไม่เป็นไรครับ Don't worry because right now we are meditator, we learner, you know, เรียนรู้ไปด้วยกัน
คือสมถะเข้าใจว่าคือตัวเองขณะนี้นี่ยังติดอยู่อะค่ะไม่แน่ใจว่าเหมือนกับว่าเราจะอยู่ตรงนั้นอยู่เสมอมีความสุขแล้วก็ไม่ไปไหนค่ะแล้วก็วิปัสสนาน่าจะเป็นระดับที่สูงกว่าซึ่งขณะนี้ยังทำไม่ได้ค่ะไม่ทราบว่าเขาจะเข้าใจถูกหรือเปล่าค่ะหลวงพ่อ
เรียกหลวงพี่ก็ได้นะหรือพระอาจารย์ก็ได้
คือติดเรียกหลวงพ่อพระอาจารย์ค่ะไม่ทราบจะเข้าใจถูกไหมครับอาจารย์ความเข้าใจตรงนี้ระหว่าง mindfulness
กับ concentration สมถะ
ค
่
ะ
and mindfulness vipassana
ค่ะ not sure whether the different whether it's just like something that is sticking with some feeling and never grow up it's still there forever
yeahYou have experience, yeah, I understand. You have experience. And then, you are very lucky. I guarantee you are very lucky to come here and understand more about Vipassana meditation. Very close concentration and Vipassana meditation or mindfulness meditation. But the most important,for concentration meditation, the goal for one-pointedness or calming or concentration, you know, samadhi for ทำใจให้สงบ need only one object, focus ต้องบริกรรมต้องบริกรรมนะถ้าเกิดเป็นสมถะต้องบริกรรมก็คืออย่างเช่นบริกรรมพุทโธบริกรรมสัมมาอรหังมีอารมณ์เดียวแล้วก็ทำให้จิตสงบ That's all for samatha nothing if you need the peaceful mind you need the calming mind you go somewhere the quiet place in the solitude and then you practiceFocus your mind on something. No need for Buddha, Buddha. Even Jesus cry, Jesus cry. Or even Muhammad, Nabi Muhammad, whatever. Even your father, mother, or dead mom. That's the object of theconcentration meditation one object okay you never worry about the other's object that's the meditation and your goal just to calming your mind and to calm your mind but vipassanaOr mindfulness. Mindfulness ภาษาไทยคืออะไรครับ คือสติครับ But concentration meditation สมาธิ okay or calmness สมาธิสมาธิสติไม่เหมือนกันแต่ว่าเป็นพี่น้องกันใกล้เคียงกัน อาศัยซึ่งกันและกันเวลาปฏิบัติวิปัสสนาเวลาปฏิบัติสมถะสมถะวิปัสสนาเขาชอบใช้สมถะวิปัสสนาเวลาปฏิบัติสมถะเราปฏิบัติสมาธิไม่ต้องใช้สติก็ได้แต่ถ้าเวลาปฏิบัติวิปัสสนาต้องใช้ทั้งสองแต่ใช้สติให้มากสมาธิใช้โดยส่วนมากเขาใช้คณิกะสมาธิ or momentary concentration or short very short concentration no need for deep meditation as the base or foundation for vipassana meditation but vipassana everything as your object ทุกสิ่งทุกอย่างเป็นอารมณ์ของวิปัสสนาแต่ว่าเขาแยกโดยย่อก็คือเป็นอารมณ์หลักอารมณ์รองอารมณ์ย่อยอริยาบทหรือไม่ก็อริยาบทหลักอริยาบทย่อยแยกลงไปให้เห็น it mean your object even your object you as a subject right subject and then something come to you that's object can be divided into two. One main object in this technique, rising, falling are used. Rising, falling. And then sub-object or minor object, whatever you call. Minor object or arom rong.อารมณ์รองเวลาโยมนั่งกรรมฐาน rising falling โยมได้ยินเสียงใครคุยกันได้ยินเสียงพัดลมอันนี้โยมต้องปฏิเสธไหมเมื่อมันปรากฏชัดปฏิเสธไหมปฏิบัติแนววิปัสสนานี้ต้องปฏิเสธเหมือนสมาธิไหมไม่ต้องปฏิเสธแต่สมาธิถ้าโยมปฏิบัติสมาธินี่โยมสนใจไหมเสียงพัดลมไม่ต้องสนใจเพราะโยมสนใจอะไรเพราะโยมสนใจเฉพาะบริกรรมเฉพาะอารมณ์เดียวไม่ใช่อารมณ์หลักถ้ามีหลักก็ต้องมีรองแต่นี้อารมณ์หลักอย่างเดียวคืออาจจะเป็นอารมณ์อาจจะเป็นบทสวดหรืออะไรก็แล้วแต่พุทโธสัมมาอรหังพ่อแม่เยซูนบีมูฮัมหมัดหรืออะไรก็แล้วแต่นะ this would be theconcentration object but vipassana objects all phenomena in Buddhism we have four foundations four categories of foundation we call patthanWhy four foundation? Foundation is one is a physical or bodily foundation. You contemplate your body. For example, rising falling is our body. And to me, a main object. This is the first one, physical foundation. And the second one, sensation.Or feeling, you contemplate about your feeling. Vedana, thank you. You never reject when you're feeling. For example, the guy you sit with Thai, you cannot sit as a Thai, Thai traditional. You know, sitting in the sideways, you know, very very hurt, you know, painful, and that's.Your vipassana object. It's good. Vipassana never reject everything, our object, you know. You say pain, and then back to your rising, falling main object. That's the second one, sensation. But that's not mean only painful or even happiness, your feeling as well.Your sensation, but difficult to note happiness, right? Happy time. For example, you have the party, or congratulation party, something, promotion party, whatever party. It's difficult for you to make a note at that time, and then you lost your concentration, you lost your mindfulness, you know. That's the second we call sensation. Or even neither painful nor happy, neutral as well, our feeling, but difficult to be aware of it. That's why we stress on only painful sensation, because very clear, very apparent for the painful object, painful feeling. This is the second one, is a sensation or feeling. And the third one, thinking. Whatever you're thinking, especially indecent thinking, mixed with or associated with lust or greed, lust, rakha, or greed, lopa, and even with hatred or anger, hatred, anger, resentment, this kind of feeling or hate feeling, that's we call the thinking, the third foundation of mindfulness meditation. Or even your delusion, your thinking sometimes deluded, or at that time is without taking note, making note. So at that time, you are supposed to acknowledge, to be aware of it, of meditation. So thinking as well as the foundation of our mindfulness meditation. This is the third one. And the last one, the last component, we say phenomenon or phenomena, but this because many things phenomena. Whatever arise in you, in your mind, you know, and then your mind, has a radar, you know, to catch on it, you know. That's a phenomena. In this sense, the Buddha said many dhamma. That's why the Buddha say dhammanuppassana satipatthana. Dhamma, not dhammo, different. Dhammo is a singular, but dhamma is plural. But this dhamma translate into Thai or into English, we call phenomena, or we call things. That's the dhamma. For example, khanha, thoughts, see, khanha, and the other dhamma, in see, thought, this kind of thing, we call the phenomena very delicate, very subtle, you know, very subtle. So four foundations make the difference between samatha and vipassana meditation, or calmness and mindfulness meditation. Okay? Right now, but vipassana, you compare yourself as right now you are in Thailand for the you are non-Thai, okay? You are non-Thai right now, you are in Thailand. One day you get back your country. You get back your home country. For example, you are from the Philippines, you are home. Thailand, your home is a main object. Thailand is minor object. But for some of you, Thai, right? You are Thai. Thai is main object. When you go somewhere around the world or worldwide, and one day you get back to Thailand, you get back to main object. Okay? Minor object and main object. Minor object and main object could be only one. For example, you are Thai, okay, you cannot be the others. You cannot be non-Thai. And then you go somewhere, you are Thai, that means you are from Thailand. You go anywhere around the world, it means minor object. Wherever, Japan, Korea, the Philippines, Australia, and then you get back to your main object, this comparison. Or even you are non-Thai according to your country, you know, as a comparison. This is very important for the beginner. Otherwise, you will get lost. I mean, not get lost into the deep concentration, but get lost how to practice, you know, how to deal with your object, you know, deal with your object. If you are never analyzed, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, he said, analytical meditation. Analytical meditation. It means you have to analyze, you know. For meditation, in this sense, analyze is mean main object, minor object, something like that. And then you can understand more about how to develop. And please talk to your master, if you have a doubt. Please give a report to him or her, you know. And then she or he, you know, can help you with the improvement, you know, your improvement about this technique. Why we use this technique? Because this technique is between, you know, some of you never practiced before, you can practice. Some of you used to practice calmness meditation, samatha, right? And then you can promote your meditation into next level, you know. You can change your this. Does not mean you forget all, no, impossible. Because we practice for long, you have practiced for long, you cannot forget all. But you have to make it as the foundation, as the base for meditation, vipassana meditation. And then your meditation will improve more and more. Okay? So, in the end of my talk, thank you very much for your listening. I hope you enjoy and learn the theoretical, aspect before we go to practical aspect. And during that time, you can improve yourself, make yourself as the tool for a meditation practice. As we say, know yourself, through yourself, and for yourself and society. The Buddha only showed the way. We or you walk the path. the master open your door. You must enter by yourself. Okay? Right now, thank you very much. I end this session.